Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. It's been a while since I've last made a Lego house. You guys wanted me to do it, so ladies and gentlemen, the time has come. We have finally done it. We built a Lego house. What's up, guys? It's me, Ty, and in today's video, we're going to be taking a look at this extremely, extremely fancy modern house. This is built on four base plates, four 32 by 32 base plates. Now, this is a gigantic house, and there's a lot to explain throughout this video, but let's start in the front. Now, the front just really sets the tone for the rest of the house. I included different styles of landscaping. On the right side, we have more of a hot, tropical, dry climate type of environment where we have some cactus, some yellow flowers, we have a palm tree, various other bushes, and even some rocks in different colors. And then on the left side, we have something that kind of resembles where I'm from, which is like the Pacific Northwest, and that is just, you know, sort of like a coniferous or evergreen portion where we have this really super neat pine tree. And I have to freaking give a shout out to my boy Dan the Fan, because he actually showed me this really cool leaf weaving technique. I absolutely love this. There's various ways you can enter this house. You can enter it through the garage, which does have a car and a tool chest and also a storage unit, as well as a pretty sexy collage of some rims. But we're gonna take the main entrance way, which is down this pathway and through this door. And then we enter the living room. Pretty open and spacious, which is what I aimed for. But most importantly, I want to give it, you know, kind of give it a cool, chill, you know, kind of vibe. So we have a sports themed room. And by sports, I'm talking about kayaking and surfing. So we have some surfboards on the wall and a kayak. And then we enter the next room, and this room is extremely open. There's a lot of things packed into this one room. First off, the dining room. We have a large table here to keep everybody warm. Not sure why you would want to necessarily be warm when it's a tropical vacation climate that you're situated in. But just in case, we also have a fireplace, a furnace. And then finally, we have our kitchen, which has sort of a bar area with some wine glasses hanging. And then we also have the main kitchen, which has pretty much everything that a mom could need. We have a refrigerator, pantry, oven, and a lot of other things that I'm not going to go deep into. And if me and the boys want to like watch a football game or something like that, Outer Banks or some cool show, then we can play it on the TV screen. You gotta go when you gotta go. So there's also a bathroom. If you enter this door, we have a very spacious bathroom with a lot of things, including a toilet, a sink, and if you're a little constipated and, you know, it's not coming out very well, then you can simply read a book. If we come back to the main room and we take this other door, we go out to the outside back area that has a lot of things. First off, the pool. There's various items, including floaties, and for all the adrenaline freaks, we have a diving board, and for all the kids, we have a slide. There's water guns, there's also life vests and flippers. And then for all the Karens, or, you know, the people that don't like the pleasure of swimming, which is kind of ridiculous, there's some chairs where you can just sit down and get splashed in the face. And then if we go around this side, we have an outdoor area for all the guys, because, I mean, trust me, I'm a guy, I know. Guys love barbecuing. So we have a freaking barbecue place back here. Maybe cook up some ribs, maybe cook up some really good barbecue for the boys. And then finally, in this back section, we have the outdoor dining area all the way back to the inside of the house. And by the inside, I'm talking about the main living room area. We have the staircase, which takes you up to the second floor of the house. So the second floor is where all the, you know, just the places to sleep and lounge are. First off, we have an indoor movie theater. This indoor movie theater can play pretty much any movie if you want. If you're a guy like me who likes some of the Fast and Furious movies, you can play whatever you want and just chill with all your friends. And then we come down this hallway, and we have the arcade. Now, this arcade is for the kids. I mean, of course, if you're on vacation and it's like a family reunion, you probably got some kids. So the kids can lounge in here and do all they want. They can play some arcade games, they can shoot some hoops, or they can simply just play on this like little gaming table. They had these at Costco, and it was like pretty cool, so I figured I'd make it. And then there's two different bedrooms to this house. The first one is the master bedroom, which is down the hallway. The master bedroom is pretty large. There are quite a bit of things, but in particular, I wanted to make it musical themed. So we have some vinyl records hanging on the wall, as well as a record player. You guys know I love records, so had to include this. Let's see what this record plays, shall we? And then we come into the bathroom, which is pretty open and spacious, and it has everything you would need. The only thing that I could complain about this is while you're taking a shower, people are gonna see you through the window. So, yikes. We don't want to see none of that, ladies and gentlemen. Sorry. Every master bedroom has to have a place to change, so we have a walk-in closet with various clothing accessories. Some pretty hype-beast stuff, if you ask me. And then the next room is accessible through the arcade room, and that is the kids' bedroom. Now, I didn't want to give this like a specific gender theme, but I will say I kind of ended up making this boys themed because it's actually Minecraft themed. You guys know how much I love Minecraft. By the way, guys, hop onto my Minecraft server, tdbricks.aternos.me. Also, it'd actually be hilarious if I'm playing Minecraft and someone hops on using that link. But yeah, I believe this is the first house I've ever made out of like my 6 years on YouTube that I've actually made a third floor to a house. I'm recording this at the time that I haven't made the third floor yet, so I'm not gonna record right now.
2,000 years later.
Okay, well, there you go. I finished the third floor. There is a pool table because I love pool, and you can see my sig fig is kind of having a hard time there getting the balls in, but you know, it is what it is. There's also sort of like a sit-down area where you can gather with friends and talk and socialize and enjoy the pleasant view, which is outside. As you can see, we have a bunch of people just looking outside. If you want, you could probably jump off this balcony into the pool, but I mean, that's a little risky, so I wouldn't do that if I were you.
Wow, boys. That video was not easy to edit. So, that wraps it up. Thank you guys for watching this video. Wait, hold on.
Like, comment, share, and subscribe. This is your captain speaking. Thank you for flying on TD Bricks Airlines. I'll catch you in the next video, and keep on building.